Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah. Our topic for this Ramadan, inshallah, will be pictures from the life of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It's going to be like pictures will be chosen from a pool of the seerah of the Prophet, of thousands of pictures. Inshallah, we'll pick up only a few hundreds. And we will put them in an album-like, and inshallah, we'll try to keep them in order, chronological order, and we'll keep in mind in selection of these pictures that we are going to do two things. Number one, telling the story, and number two, to preserve memories. Of course, when you arrange for an album, you will do editing and arrangement and cropping and putting things in size. And eventually, when we have the full album, we'll sit back and review it with the family and the children to know more about the life of and the biography of the life of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So this is not a history book, this is not a biography book, nor any religious book. So this is only some selected situations or selected events or selected incidents with some comments, some thoughts related to this picture, inshallah, will be the main thing here. Out of those pictures we have chosen from the seerah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I will read the text in Arabic and translate, then I will give my comments. Before then, I would like to title this page with a voice in the wilderness cries out. I started writing these pages when I was visiting my son in New Hampshire, and I was on the banks of the river Mascoma River, which is located in a very beautiful area, looks like a wilderness. It is north of Corniche, where the novelist J.D. Salinger, the author of Catcher in the Rye, lived and died last year. It is south of Hanover, where Dartmouth School or Dartmouth College there. And as you know, Dartmouth is one of the Ivy League schools, which is, its motto is voice in the wilderness cries. It is taken from the Bible, the Old Testament, and which means this center of enlightenment, which was built in 1769 in the wilderness. It was a center for learning and education. I wonder if we want to find a motto for Islam, what would we choose? I would choose compassion, since we know this is the description of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, job, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. Also, to make it a trio, I will choose truth and justice. وَتَمَّتْ كَلِمَةُ رَبِّكَ صِدْقًا وَعَدْلًا. I wrote those pages sitting at the bank of the river where my grandson was feeding the ducks under supervision of his dad. And in my thought, I went thousands of miles, probably 6,000, to my hometown city of Damascus and to my neighborhood, which is a very modest house in the old city, with a center masjid called the Black Cauldron. It is a kind of musalla. Across the street of that masjid, there is a tomb of a sage with the name Khwarizmi. But my children had read the name as Khwarizmi, and they went to their high school, and they spread the word that the Khwarizmi, the great mathematician who invented algebra and his name spilled over algorithm. He's buried in the backyard of their grandparents' house. But the truth is that this is one of the tomb of the righteous people, and some of the ignorant people come to light candles seeking to have children or have happy marriages. They should better go to a counselor or something like that. So in that house where I grew up, and I used to pray at that masjid of the Black Cauldron, Al-Jurn al-Aswad, there is a large room in the lower level. We call it Al-Qa'a, the hall. And in that Qa'a, it is very kind of mysterious space. There's a lot of rumors about encounters with the extraterrestrial, and I remember from my childhood that all the dimensions meet there at that place, and sometime at night you see wooden clogs moving towards the fountain in the middle to make wudu. At any rate, in that Qa'a there is a built-in bookshelves. It is of the architect of the house, and nowadays we have instead the bars and with the special shelves to host the glasses. Alhamdulillah, those bookshelves were part of the houses in the old city in most of the cities of the Middle East, and used to host a large number of volumes of books. And one of those books was the book of Ibn Hisham. It is a book of the seerah, and I encountered that book at age 11, 12, and ever since I fell in love with this book. I don't know why. The neuroscientists say if your name is similar to the name of, or even the first letter, similar to the first letter in people who get married, it would be a successful marriage. And they have done studies. It's more than coincidence. They found boys choose their girls with the first letter of their name, similar. First letter of their names. However, whatever it is, I fell in love with this seerah of Ibn Hisham, and I have read it many, many times. As a matter of fact, I had it under my pillow. Every night when I go to bed, I would read in it. I know people put under their pillows either a copy of some script, other books, or Iliad, or Plutarch, as I have read. But for me was Ibn Hisham. The seerah of Ibn Hisham, his full name is Abdul Malik Ibn Hisham. And his seerah is a summary or based completely on the writing of Muhammad Ibn Ishaq. Muhammad Ibn Ishaq is the father of the seerah and the biography. He is probably a tabi'i or tabi'i tabi'i. He was born like Abu Hanifa in the year 80 and died in the year 150. And in his age, he probably met several of the Sahaba like Anas ibn Malik, and probably he met the last of the companions of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Abu Tufail Amir ibn Wathila al-Laythi al-Kinani, who died at the time of Umar ibn Abdul Aziz in the year 101. So Ibn Ishaq met the greatest scholars in the seerah like Muhammad ibn Muslim ibn Shihab al-Zuhri, and the others writing of Urwa ibn Zubayr and Abban ibn Uthman ibn Affan. All of these were eyewitnesses to the event of the seerah, or they studied them under the great companions of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And all of this ended up with Abd al-Malik ibn Hisham, where he gave us this great book, Sirat ibn Hisham. And we will start this selection of pictures in this album with event happened 4,000 years ago. It is Ibrahim alayhi salam. We know Ibrahim alayhi salam had lived roughly speaking, in the year 2200 before the Common Era. And his firstborn son was Ismail, alayhi salam. And we know the story of Ibrahim and Ismail. He had taken his son and her mother to live in Wadi Ghayri Dhi Zar' Inda Baytik Al-Muharram. So it is, the story goes, we know the first house built by Adam alayhi salam, it was destroyed, the foundation still there, and Ibrahim alayhi salam left Hajar and her son Ismail as a baby in the area, and the Arab tribes in that time, Jurhum, he lived among them and he flourished. So Ibrahim alayhi salam also prayed hard to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that to send unto them a prophet. رَبِّ وَبَعَثْ فِيهِمْ رَسُولًا مِّنْهُمْ يَتْلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتِكَ وَيُعَلِّمُهُمُ الْكِتَابَ وَالْحِكْمَةَ وَيُزَكِّيهِمْ إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ. Similar verses we find in the Deuteronomy from the Old Testament, where it says, وَاسْتَعْلَنَ مِنْ جِبَالِ فَارَانِ وَمَعَهُ أُلُوفُ الْأَطْهَارِ, predicting the coming of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, from the mountain of Faran, which means Mecca and surrounding area, and around him thousands of the pious people, which means the Sahaba al-Kiram. And another verse from the same chapter, and I will erect a prophet from among them, and I will put in his mouth my words, and he will order them what to do. This is what Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said, ana da'watu abi ibrahim wa bushra akhi isa wa ru'ya ummi. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, I am the answer to the prayer of Ibrahim, and I am the glad tiding or the good news given by Isa alayhi salam. We know Isa was 600 years or 570 before the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and we read in Surah As-Saff that Isa has said in the Quran, وَإِذْ قَالَ عِيسَى بْنُ مَرْيَمَ يَا بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ إِنِّي رَسُولُ اللَّهِ إِلَيْكُمْ مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا بَيْنَ يَدَيَّ مِنَ التَّوْرَاةِ وَمُبَشِّرًا بِرَسُولٍ يَأْتِي مِنْ بَعْدِ اسْمُهُ. And we read in the Gospels that Isa alayhi salam has said, I am inni dhahibun ila rabbi wa rabbikum likay yursila lakum al-fariqit alladhi sayati ilaykum bit-ta'wil, which is means that I am going to my Lord and your Lord, but he will send unto you a prophet which will bring you revelation. So this is the story of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. 4,000 years ago, he was the answer to prayer of Ibrahim alayhi salam, and the good news from Isa alayhi salam before he was born in the year 571 in Mecca. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله والسلام عليكم.